welcome. Today we're going to be doing some parabolic art, something I think is really fun, and I think you're really going to enjoy doing it. So let's get started. Step one, make sure your hands are nice and clean. Just wash them, you know, scrub them like this, sort of. And always make sure you have your first aid kit handy and off to the side just in case, you know, emergencies and such. Just put that back right here. Step two, make sure you have your stuff set up, your markers right here, a nice array of colors. It's nice. It's real nice. I'm gonna go with the green. We're gonna make sure the markers have ink. Just gonna give it a little shake, a little tap. Make sure it's working on the tip of my finger so we don't get it on the paper. Shake it up a bit. I'm gonna grab the ruler. You always want a ruler to make sure the lines are straight. Just gonna. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your parabolic template and your ruler and your marker, and you're gonna start at one point and draw a straight line to the next point. Just like this. Nice and straight. Line it up. Keep it straight. Just gonna draw a line. Nice straight line. Just like that. I'm gonna look at that. Isn't that nice? Now we're just gonna continue going on, point to point. Nice straight lines. It's best if you use a cork back ruler. It helps your paper stay where it needs to be, not slide around. Just like that. Simple as that. Just gonna keep going on down the line, point to point. From here to here. Some little known facts about parabolic line designs are that they were used in ancient architecture, such as the Eiffel Tower. They're used in skateboard ramps. And they're also used in pool transitions. Just keep on going down the line here. This first quadrant is almost done. Just got one more line to draw. Just line this up here like this, and there we have it. Next step, turn the cap to the marker. Make sure it's nice and airtight. You don't want those Sharpies to dry out. I'm gonna go with the magenta for the next quadrant. Shake it up a bit. Make sure it's got ink. Test it on my finger. It's looking good. Gonna rotate 90 degrees counterclockwise to get started on the next quadrant. Start with the first line, going point to point, just like the last quadrant. Look at that. I think this is such a good color. Keep on going down. So recently, I was volunteering down at the Arts and Crafts Fair at the DeSoto Square Mall, and I showed this to all the children. They really had a blast with it. The colors were just great. They came up with really creative ways to draw parabolic lines and design. See that? Isn't that nice? We've got one more. We'll be on to quadrant three. Yep, just like that. Yep, there it is. And we'll rotate the paper to the next quadrant after we seal up this marker nice and tight. Let's move on down the line. Ooh, this is a nice shade of blue. I'm gonna make sure there's ink in this one, just like the other two. Grab my ruler. So we're starting on quadrant three. Start lining things up here. Point to point, just like the other two quadrants. Nice straight lines all the way down. It's looking good so far. You know, this shade of blue reminds me of when I went to Germany 2 summers ago with my brother. We had a good time. It was beautiful skies. We stayed in Hamburg. I miss him. I should give him a call. Look at that. We're on to the fourth line, third quadrant. It's nice and easy lines. Let's just draw another line here. And looks like we've only got one more to go. Just line it up, make it straight. Don't let the ruler slip. All right, there we go. Well, this workspace is looking a little bit messy, so I'm gonna make sure this is on tight and let's clean things up a bit. You never wanna work with a messy workspace. It just makes things harder to control. Gets out of order, you might lose your ruler. And we're gonna rotate one more time. Counterclockwise, 90 degrees. Grab the ruler. I'm gonna go with this nice shade of orange. Make sure it's got ink. Don't wanna get it on the paper. So we're on the home stretch here, hang in there. Just got a few more points to draw lines from. And it's looking good. I'm excited to see the final product. This must be how Van Gogh felt when he was finishing up the Mona Lisa. Look at that line, nice and straight. Just a few more. Line it up just like so. Just draw straight lines. Nice and simple. It's important to keep things straight and orderly. No one likes a sloppy workspace. There we go. We've got two more. From here to here. Look at that. It's exciting. One more to go. Let's line it up. And we're finished. And close this cap. Make sure there's no air. Set that back down. Line everything back up. I like it neat. And we're done. Great job, guys. One thing you never want to do is draw the lines without a ruler. It gets haywire and goes all over the place. It could ruin your masterpiece in a second flat. So always, always use a ruler.